In this video episode, I'm going to help you on how to do basic setup for your Omron Cj1M CPU13 PLC programming activities. This is Omron Cj1M CPU13 PLC. A modular type PLC. It uses ID211 input card and OD211 output card. Let's begin. Switch on the circuit breaker to energize the PLC unit. Next, select what type of communication cable to be used. There are two cables available, USB to RS232C cable and a combination cable, USB RS232C plus CN226, DHF 10 connector. In this basic setup, we will use USB to RS232C cable for our Cj1M PLC unit. Open your laptop, go to Device Manager to see where the communication cable is connected. Click Ports, the cable is located at COM3. Close the Device Manager tab. Open CX Programmer version 9.7 PLC software. Welcome to ID211 and OD211 cards setup. First, we need to accomplish the PLC setup. Click New icon or press Ctrl N, a new tab will appear. It is where you can select your PLC type. You may type your device name. Select device type, Cj1M. Click Settings, select the CPU type, CPU13. That is the actual CPU model of the PLC unit. Next, click Network Type. Since RS232C cable is connected, select SysMac Way. Click Settings, click Driver, and select COM3 at port name. Click OK. Once the PLC setup is finalized, click OK. And here's on how to set up the I/O cards. Double-click I/O table and unit setup. A new tab will appear. Select main rack. We need to add the I/O cards. In slot 00, it is where the input card will be designated. Click Add Unit icon, click Basic I/O, and select Cj1WID211, DC input unit. And click OK. As you can see, the input card has been added to slot 00. Next, for OD211 card. Select slot 01, click Add Unit icon, click Basic I/O, and select Cj1WOD211, Transistor Output Unit. OD211 output card is syncing output card. And click OK. Next, let's select the programming code designations for input and output cards. Go to Menu, click Options, select Rack/Slot Start Addresses. Select Slot Start Addresses Settings. And OK. In the Start Addresses Settings tab, double-click slot 00, choose your own addresses for input cards, you may start with 0 channel. And click OK. And click Add icon to set the output card. Change slot 0 to 1, because that is the output card location or designation. Some PLCs uses 10CH or 11CH like CPM1A PLC model, and CP1A series uses 100CH or 101CH. So, let's start with a 100 channel address for the output card. Click OK. OK. How to put I/O table addresses permanently to our PLC unit. Go to Programming Software Interface. In order to transfer the I/O table data to the PLC, select PLC from menu area, and click Work Online or press Ctrl W connect to the PLC by selecting Yes. The PLC unit is now online and in run mode. Go back to PLC I/O table tab, click Options, and select Transfer to PLC. And click OK. Then transfer the I/O table and S/IO unit parameters. Transfer results will show on the screen. Click OK. And put the PLC in run mode. Close the tab. And you may now start your basic PLC programming activities. So, that's all on how to do basic I/O table setup for your Omron Cj1M CPU13 PLC. If you find this video interesting and useful to others, you may consider subscribing, like and share and hit the notification bell for more updates to come. And follow us at Facebook, Facebook page, Warden's Corner. See you on next video tutorial on how to create a simple logic program in CX Programmer PLC software. Have a nice day ahead. Thank you and goodbye.